The Secret Service is calling their response to an apparent attempted assassination of former President Trump, the second in as many months, a success.
This afternoon, we learned the suspect, Ryan Ruth, is facing several felony charges. Investigators say Ruth hid in the bushes at Trump International Golf Course, but did not fire his weapon. He was spotted by a Secret Service agent who was several holes ahead of Trump doing a sweep of the area. That agent shot at Ruth, who took off through the brush. Authorities say a witness snapped a picture of his car, which helps sheriff's deputies track him down.
Did the one witness make it all possible? The answer is unequivocally yes.
And the agent's hypervigilance and the detailed swift action was textbook. And I commend them and our partners for an exemplary response in keeping former President Trump safe.
Now, Trump was not hurt. President Biden and Vice President Kamala Harris are calling for an end to the political violence and more support for the Secret Service. We are now 50 days away from the election, and this second apparent assassination attempt on Donald Trump is raising major security questions, and not only for the former president, but for all others in the race.
Morgan Wolf spoke with a security expert about what went wrong and what could be done to better protect all Secret Service subjects. Morgan?
The former Secret Service agent that I spoke to actually has experience covering golf courses in particular, and he has some criticism of his former agency for this particular incident, given Trump's assassination attempt from July. But he is hopeful that Congress can step in to help the Secret Service.
A round of golf turned into chaos at Trump International Golf Course.
We can't have things getting that close and this close to a general election.
Mike Olson served as a Secret Service agent for 2 decades. He says the agency has security techniques specifically for golf courses, which the acting director of the Secret Service says was effective. The agent walking a hole ahead of the president spotted the suspect's rifle at that fence line 400 to 500 yards away from them. The FBI says they then shot 4 to 6 rounds at the suspect.
The problem is that extended perimeter of security that should exist.
The president is aware that he has highest levels of protection that the Secret Service is providing him.
The acting director says that Trump was playing a round of golf off the record with layered levels of protection.
Off the record is maybe even going in a very small contingent of cars without police cars and things like that. Truly, you know, kind of undercover, so to speak.
Due to the level of the predictability of where the former president usually golfs near Mar-a-Lago, Olson says that there needs to be more resources, even if it is an off-the-record outing. Meanwhile, President Biden spoke about the agency today.
One thing I want to make clear, the service needs more help, and I think the Congress should respond to their needs if they, in fact, need more services.
Olson echoing that same sentiment.
Whether it's Congress providing resources or Department of Homeland Security or whoever, we across the board need to be elevating the resources that are given to the Secret Service and all of the protectees from here until the election.
Members of a bipartisan House panel looking into the first assassination attempt against the former president are now asking for a briefing on the second threat to the former president's life.
I'm hearing that actually a very healthy discussion coming from both sides of the aisle. I think your introduction, the report, is correct. Both Republicans and Democrats, frankly, Americans, are very concerned that this is happening.
Minnesota Congressman and House Majority Whip Tom Emmer sounding off on the apparent second assassination attempt, saying he's glad the president is okay.